Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Alexandra, this is Harriet, and today we are gonna be talking through how we made over our teeny tiny rental bathroom. I said we to like include her, but she seems to be a little touchy. I am gonna walk you through. Nope, she wants in. Nope, she doesn't. So I spent just about $400. One of the items I did buy is kind of a ridiculous splurge, which brought the price up a lot, but I hope you guys take bits and pieces from this video that help you make over your small space too.
If you're new here, I recently moved onto the top floor of an old Victorian house with my two cats, Harriet and Marty, and my partner, Andrew. Follow me in this series where I transform this entire apartment room to room, giving you on budget and renter friendly solutions. You're watching my rental reno.
When we moved into this apartment, this bathroom actually had zero closed storage. Like, that is not an exaggeration. The only thing that was in this bathroom were open shelves. I actually thought they were really cool and trendy when we first moved in, but I quickly realized once I started unpacking all my stuff, everything looked really messy. There was really no way to hide it. The shelves were super narrow, so I couldn't put baskets. The first thing we did was take down some shelves, paint the whole bathroom white, and then really kind of started from scratch. So I knew right away that I had to replace the really big mirror and the kind of like old Hollywood vanity lights situation that was going on. And so I asked my landlord before I made these changes, because they were big changes. So I asked her if I could replace these things. She was totally fine with them. Though, when we took the mirror down and the light, the wall underneath was like purple and yellow, and there was just a lot going on. I think people had painted layers and layers and layers of paint around this mirror, so there was actually like a dip in the wall, and it was just kind of a disaster of a situation. So we really had to sand this wall down. Once the wall was all smoothed out, I gave it a fresh coat of white paint. Now, this wall is never gonna look perfect. It's an old house, it has character. And I think when you're in these rental situations, you just gotta go with the flow and try and make the room look, you know, the best that it can look. So I actually really loved the natural wood tone of these shelves, but I found that with the mirror I sourced and a couple other touches to this space that you'll see later in this video, I just didn't feel like the wood was working. So I decided to paint these white, and I feel like this makes the space feel so much brighter and so much airier. We also added a toilet roll holder and this beautiful light that cost under $20. It's an $18 light. It has this beautiful gold kind of touch to it. Such an amazing price for a light, because who wants to spend $1 billion on a rental light? One of the biggest game changers in this space was this wall cabinet. It's 4 inches wide, so it fits so nicely in this little cubby of a wall. What a game changer. Like, it adds storage. It doesn't take up a lot of space. You almost don't even notice it's there. And I think this is such a good tip if you are making over your small bathroom. Look for spots, unexpected spots to add storage. Find a solution that's very slim that will give you lots of vertical storage but not take up a large footprint. This wall cabinet is linked down below. It was such a good find and really solved that problem of not having any storage. So on the back of the door, they had this like wooden hook. It was cute, but I didn't really want to paint it, and I wanted to add in something a little more, you know, cute and functional. So I found these hooks on Amazon, really inexpensive. They're linked down below. I just put 2 on the back of the door because that's all we need for this space. The next hook that I'm adding to this space is right beside the sink. So this is for the hand towel. So when I found this woman hook, it's a lady, I've named her Melinda, because like, why not? She just looks like a Melinda. She was very expensive, but she's handmade by an artist that lives in the States. And I was like, I need Melinda in my bathroom to hold my hand towel. That was just like my thought process. I talk about this a lot, but I feel like if there's a piece of decor that you really love, splurge on it. You'll have it forever. I plan to bring Melinda with me to any other space I move into. And she makes me so happy. Like, I walk into this bathroom and it's just the cutest little addition ever. Like, the screws to hold her up are also her boobs. Anyways, moving on. I really feel that like, if you fall in love with a hook named Melinda as much as I did, splurge on it, and then you can cut corners in other areas. The next thing I added to this space was this gorgeous mirror. It's that accessory that you obviously need to use every day, but you can have fun with. Guys, there are so many fun mirrors out there. I encourage you to look around. Maybe I'll link a few of, you know, my favorite fun ones down below. Yeah, I just think it's such a beautiful addition to the bathroom. And this was the piece I was talking about. It's a little bit of a lighter wood. So I didn't feel like the shelves matched the mirror, which is why I opted to paint them white. So I had this floor mirror that IKEA gifted me when I moved into this apartment. It was in my, what I bought for my new apartment haul. And so we actually took the floor part of this mirror off and turned it into a hanging mirror. This is another tip for a small bathroom. You wanna look for every opportunity to add, you know, a function to the walls. So for me, that was looking behind the door and thinking, how can I maximize this like dark space behind the door? When I'm in the bathroom, the door is closed, so it opens up all that space and I get a floor length mirror out of it. Right here, yeah. So a really fun addition to this wall mirror is this cute little decal that says this quote. I mean, it's kind of cheesy, but also like very empowering. For $9, you can have an inspirational quote on your mirror. I'm gonna look at it every day. I'm like, yeah, I am cool. You know, little updates like this, like if you don't wanna transform your entire bathroom like I did and kind of start from the ground up, little details like this can make all the difference. So the next step was to organize, you know, all the things that I need to actually store in this bathroom. So the first thing I would suggest you do is take all of the items you need to store and lay them out. I always encourage you to purge anything. I did that beforehand. So I've grouped things into light categories. So I have my hair care stuff, I have my first aid kit, I have soap, I have hair ties, and then I have things like our electric toothbrushes, our razors. So I'm putting all of the like items into containers, I'm grouping them together, corrals things, keeps things, you know, organized in groups. Now for all of those larger items, I'm actually decanting them into these amber bottles. Amber bottles that cost like $30 for a pack of 12. These look so beautiful out on display. I find it like transforms an open shelf into a little apothecary. So I'm putting my body lotion, my hair oil that I use every day, and my toner into these jars. It's freeing up space in this very slim wall cabinet, so I can house all those like ugly things in the wall cabinet and then put these beautiful things out on display now that they're in amber glass jars. And these are also things that I use on a daily basis, so they're in easy reach, they're easy for me to access, and they transform this open shelving into functional storage that also looks beautiful. And I've used my trusty retro label maker. So many of you guys have said like, I bought that label maker and it's been life-changing for me basically. Now look at how organized this cabinet looks with everything kind of organized. It means that I know where everything is, everything has a place. Another thing I really struggled with was like, where am I gonna put all of my hair tools? So I actually got a beautiful decorative basket, what else? And I just put all of my hair tools, so my brush, my curling iron, my straightener, my hair dryer, and it, like, it looks really beautiful. And I just think this was such an amazing way to keep this stuff organized, but also in easy reach. And this one has pom-poms on it. Well, they're like kind of like tassel pom-poms, which just takes the whole pom-pom love affair like way up a notch. And then behind the door, I'm again maximizing all of that space and I'm putting a basket right in the corner, and this is where all of our extra toilet paper is gonna go. I encourage you to find a basket that holds, you know, the amount of toilet paper that comes in a pack, because then you don't have to store that toilet paper anywhere else. So you're freeing up extra storage space, you're putting everything in a decorative basket, it's stored away, and it's in easy reach. It's a win-win. So just like taking toilet paper out of the package, I think it's really important to take, you know, like Q-tips or cotton pads out of the package, and again, put them in beautiful little containers, keep them on display on an open shelf. It just saves so much space and also, you know, makes those things like into a nice decor moment. So I'm just decorating these shelves. I'm using these kind of like frosted plastic bins from Muji. I'll link them down below. All of the things that don't look so pretty, I'm storing those up on the highest shelf. How many times have I said organized in this video? Like drinking game, maybe? like take a shot every time I stay organized. I'm just putting a cute little succulent on the top shelf to complete this little nook. On the windowsill, I'm putting this really lovely tin first aid kit. I got this tin when I was in the UK. It was like $6. I've linked a similar one down below. I've seen tons on Amazon. There's a couple at HomeSense from time to time. And then beside this, I'm putting my makeup in a basket I got from the dollar store. It's a cute little gold basket. It was like $1.25. And then a candle, because, you know, every bathroom needs a candle. And then hanging from the window frame is this gorgeous pothos plant in this planter I got from HomeSense. It was $20. I love how this window looks out onto a brick wall. It feels really private. I was kind of debating hanging like a Roman shade up here, but I love how the light pours in, how we don't have to worry about our neighbors seeing us. So I thought a plant would just add a little something. It's gonna thrive in this corner because of all the sunlight it gets, and it just like totally completes this bathroom. So now for, you know, those final finishing touches to bring this bathroom together. I have a hand towel, love it, hanging off Melinda. Guys, do you notice Melinda's like carrying the bath towel? I love it. I'm also adding in a beautiful bath mat. I got this for like $10 in Morocco a couple years ago. Another tip I would encourage you guys to do, if there's one change you're gonna make in your rental bathroom, it's to hang some art. And I feel like this is a thing that a lot of people don't think about doing because they're like, art in a bathroom? But it is such a game changer. It makes your bathroom feel like, you know, homey and lived in. I went for this adorable peaches print from Society 6. I've linked it down below. It was super inexpensive. And I went for peaches because, like, you know, the peach emoji, it's like your butt. Bathroom, get it? Okay. It also just looks super fun and adds a bright pop of color. And then I'm hanging this little cute pom-pom on the doorknob. Again, like if you guys are just looking to add like cute little decor moments into your space, hang something off the door handle. It just like makes the space look so cute. When you're decorating your bathroom, all those things that like you use every day that tend to be not that cute, like a toilet brush cleaner or a little garbage bin, look for ones that are in fun colors or patterns like I have. This pink garbage can is just so adorable and I love the shade of pink. And then this toilet bowl cleaner is also really adorable. So it's just like making those mundane kind of everyday things look really beautiful, and it's gonna tie your whole space together. Bathroom accessories can be cute. They really can. Like a toilet brush holder, who knew? And now here's a couple bonus tips. These are things that I thought would help you guys at home for different bathroom organization strategies. I'm not keeping them in my bathroom because I just don't need them, but I thought they'd be helpful to you guys at home. So the first product is for people like me who don't have a ton of counter space. It's like, what do you do when you have to charge your electric toothbrush, your electric razor? This product solves that problem. It goes above the wall outlet, it sticks with an adhesive hook, and you wrap your cord underneath it so it hides it, and then the item that you're charging sits on top. So such a great solution if you wanna add a little bit of counter space and keep those, you know, chargers and stuff organized. The second product, this would actually totally work in my space because I have a pedestal sink, but what do you do when you don't have any way to store anything underneath your sink and don't have, you know, space to hang a wall cabinet like I do? These two shelves are from IKEA. They're made for pedestal sinks. They kind of like hug the sink and just add so much storage underneath there that's tucked away. And then finally, these over the door hooks are really great. This one's a little basket. This is from Solutions. So for your hair dryer or your straightening iron, just an extra way to maximize your door and use it to organize all those things that don't typically have a home in your small bathroom. And there you have it. I love how this bathroom turned out. It looks so, so different from when we moved in, and I couldn't be happier with it. I feel like it's such a nice space to get ready in every day, and I'm kind of proud at how I've added storage to this bathroom that like literally had no opportunity for clothes storage. So for real, there you have it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know in the comments down below what your favorite bathroom organization hack is from this video, or maybe from your own bathroom. I would love to know. And I will see you guys next week. Bye.